We want to use the orbit equations. In order to use the orbit equation, it should be expressed in terms of some experimentally accessible parameters. For example, if the orbit is unbounded, we must know the parameters like initial energy and trajectory, etc. Here we are going to understand more about hyperbolic orbits. Let us consider a system. It have a reduced mass mu and a velocity v0 when the mu is far from the origin at here. Okay. And here B is the impact parameter. So impact parameter is the perpendicular distance between the initial path and towards the origin. Okay. Now we can calculate the angular momentum and energy. Here the momentum and B are perpendicular. Therefore the angular momentum, that is the moment of moments, r cross b, l is equal to mu b v0, so, and e is half mu v0 square. So let us choose an example such as an inverse square law of force. In the case of an inverse square law of force, u of r is given by minus c by r. Then the equation of orbit become r is equal to r0 by 1 minus epsilon cos theta, where r0 is given by this one, l square by mu c, that we learned earlier. So l is equal to mu b v0, therefore l square is mu b square, mu square b square v0 square divided by mu c, so that you will get mu b square v0 square by c. So I am arranging it in this way. So I multiply and divide by the 2. So 2 by 2 into mu v0 square b square by c. But half mu v0 square is energy. Therefore r0 is equal to 2e b square by c. Similarly, epsilon, the eccentricity is given by square root of 1 plus E L square, 2EL square by mu C square. That is equal to square root of 1 plus 2E mu B square V0 square by C square. Again, L is substituted by mu B V0. That is equal to square root of 1 plus 4E square B square by C square. So that is again by multiplying and dividing by with the 2. And rearranging half mu v0 square as e. That is equal to square root of this one, 1 plus 2eby by 2eb by c all square. Okay, that is the eccentricity. Right. Now let us calculate the minimum value of r. R is minimum when theta is pi. Because r is equal to r0 by 1 minus epsilon cos theta. At theta is equal to pi, cos theta is equal to minus 1. Okay. Therefore, r minimum is equal to r0 by 1 plus epsilon. So that is equal to, we will substitute for r0 and epsilon. That is equal to 2eb square by c by 1 plus square root of 1 plus 2eb by c all square. Now let E tends to infinity, that means infinite energy. E has infinite energy. So let us look about R minimum. So this one is, so this 2eb square is a big term. Therefore, comparing to 1, this is too large. Therefore, you can avoid this one and this one. Therefore, 1 plus square root of 1 plus 2eb by c all square is equal to square root of 2EB by C all square. Okay, we are avoiding this one in the inside square root and this one, because E is a very large quantity. Comparing that, 1 is a small one, small quantity. So square root of 2EB by C in the all square become 2EB by C. So that is 2EB square by C by 2EB by C. That is approximately equal to B. B is the impact parameter. Okay, this is R minimum. So what we can say is, as E tends to infinity, R minimum tends to B, the impact parameter. So therefore, the value of R minimum lies in between 0 and B. That we can say. Okay, the very minimum value is 0. It can be extend up to B, impact parameter. Now we can calculate the angle of asymptotes. Okay, asymptotes are these dotted lines. So here also we are letting R tends to infinity. Okay, so here this angle is theta A. That's called angle of asymptote. Theta A is the angle of asymptotes, and this extension, this angle is psi, that is called deflection angle. That is very important, deflection angle. So deflection angle calculated by this angle is pi minus this angle, that is 2 theta. So therefore, deflection angle psi is equal to pi minus 2 theta a. In this way, you can calculate the deflection angle. And cos theta a. So how we can calculate cos theta a? Here we are letting r tends to infinity. Our orbit equation is r is equal to r0 by 1 minus epsilon cos theta. R is infinity when the denominator is 0. That means 1 minus epsilon cos theta is equal to 0, or epsilon cos theta is equal to 1. Therefore, cos theta A is equal to 1 by epsilon. In this way also you can calculate the angle of asymptotes. Okay, a very important problem that you can work out is the Rutherford scattering problem. You try to solve that problem using this idea, and we can use this equation to understand the orbit of comets and the trajectory of charged particle scattering of an atomic nucleus.